Hezbollah has confirmed one of its senior commanders has been killed in an Israeli airstrike on the outskirts of Beirut. Israel's military also confirmed it had killed Fuad Shukr. It blames Mr. Shukr for an attack last week in the Israeli-occupied Golan Heights. He is the most senior figure from the Iran-backed militia group to be killed in the 10 months of conflict with Israel. The strike happened a few hours before Hamas leader Ismail Haniyeh was killed in Iran's capital of Tehran. Speaking in Tel Aviv this morning, Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says Israel will continue to put pressure on opposing forces.
Citizens of Israel, these are challenging days we are facing. Since the strike in Beirut, we have been hearing threats from every direction. We are prepared for every scenario, and we will be together, we will be determined against any threat. Israel will make anyone who is against us pay a very heavy price, no matter in which arena.
Well, joining us live now is the founder of the National Iranian American Council, Trita Parsi. Good to have you with us today, Trita. Thank you. So no confirmation just yet, but your thoughts on who did it and what it means for peace in the Middle East?
Well, I think at this time, there really isn't much doubt that it is the Israelis that are behind this. This was clearly a signal aimed at maximum embarrassment of the Iranians because they did it in Tehran, the capital of Iran, on the day of the inauguration of the new Iranian president. But maximum embarrassment also then means that the Israelis understood that that would yield maximum likelihood of an Iranian retaliation. And there are now reports that the Iranians have ordered retaliation, not just from them, but potentially also from other actors in the region, directly at Israel. So the region is really on the tip of a major war triggered by what Israel has done in the last 24 hours. We were here back in April when the Israelis targeted the Iranian embassy in Damascus. But fortunately, in that case, because of a lot of behind-the-scenes diplomacy, despite the fact that the Iranians retaliated, a larger escalation was evaded. This right. time around, it's going to be much more difficult.
When it comes to Haniyeh, isn't anyone, and certainly Israel argues this, anyone who is part of the October 7 terror attacks a legitimate target?
Well, first of all, when it comes to what international law says on these things, it's a little bit different from what the Israelis are arguing. But more importantly, this was taking place in the territory of Iran. Any attack on the territory of another country is a violation of international law unless it's done in self-defense. There is no self-defense claim that can be made in this situation. If we had this norm become
Well, I mean, Israel
standard,
would argue that the terror attack happened in Israeli territory.
Yes, but in the sense that if you want to invoke self-defense, it means that you are actually responding to a potential attack coming from Iran. This was an attack on Iranian soil. If this norm were to be adopted and become widely accepted. And incidentally, this started with during the global war on terror, in which the United States saw justification to target terrorists in third countries. If that is to happen on a broader scale, we're going to see far more violence than we have seen in the previous decades. That is not the type of world that we want to live in.
So do you think Iran would go to war over this?
Well, let me also say another thing that is, I think, quite important in the context of this. This person that was assassinated here by the Israelis is the person that the Israelis are negotiating with for a ceasefire. So it tells you something about the actual desire on the Israeli side to get a ceasefire deal that would also bring home the Israeli hostages if they actually, in the midst of those negotiations, decide to assassinate this person. So what they have done here as well is to really set back any prospects of getting the Israeli hostages home, and it really set back any prospects of a ceasefire in Gaza. So the question really has to be here, what exactly are the Israelis trying to achieve, and what would Western countries do if the objective of the Israelis actually is to get a major escalation?
Okay, Trita, we will leave that there. Thanks for your time.